In a recent article published in The Guardian, author, writer, you know, political, really smart guy, Sidney Blumenthal, he wrote this article that I just have to talk about. And usually I don't sit here and say, hey, there's this person wrote an article. I got to discuss it because I loved it so much. But this is one of those times. Because the article was titled, "We Have Zombie Republican Presidential Candidates Enabled by an Undead Media." Obviously, a title like that's going to catch my attention, and the contents of the article are brilliant. Because what Blumenthal, just to kind of distill his points down to the most basic, and if you want to read it, there's a link in the description of the video. I encourage everybody to read it. But he talks about the fact that we have Republican candidates running for president, obviously, that have no chance at winning. Like, they have zero chance whatsoever of beating Donald Trump. Even Nikki Haley, who is surging, and I do think, personally, she is a threat to Trump, but that's only under certain circumstances that involve Donald Trump getting convicted. But as it stands right now, barring any convictions, Trump's got that nomination on lockdown. So that's the first part of it. The second part of it is, if that's the case, then why the hell are we still dealing with these people? Why am I going to news sites every day and seeing headlines that talk about Chris Christie or Vivek Ramaswamy or, you know, who else is left? I guess Ron DeSantis. Those people don't matter. Nikki Haley, you know, ostensibly doesn't matter. But the media is still trying to force these people down our throats. They're hosting them for interviews. They're still having these idiotic Republican debates because the media needs it. Because the media wants it. The people have said, we don't want it. We don't care. I mean, that most recent Republican presidential debate, the ratings were down to like 3 million. It's doing not very well, but that's still 3 million more than the network probably would have pulled in otherwise. So they will keep beating this dead horse, pretending that there is a horse race, because it brings in the ratings. It brings in the eyeballs that bring in the ad dollars and so on and so forth. And the public has to suffer through it. The media is manipulating this race by keeping it alive when it's just time to pull the plug, guys. You know, you've been doing CPR on these Republican candidates for 3 months now, and there's still no heartbeat. They're not breathing on their own. It's time to let them go. Let them walk into the light. We don't need to do a Weekend at Bernie's thing and prop them up and act like, no, I'm still here. I just have a toothache and that's why my face is bandaged. That ain't happening. These candidates are not going to do anything meaningful. At least definitely not your Ramaswamis and your Chris Christies. So stop devoting time to them. Stop making us think about them, because every time you run a story on these people, there's another more important story that doesn't get the airspace. Donald Trump is out there talking like Adolf Hitler. Donald Trump is facing 91 felony charges in addition to the fraud trial still going on in New York. Don't you think that's a little bit more important? We've got an economy that is actually starting to recover. Gas prices lower than they've been on Thanksgiving than, you know, the last 5 years. Maybe those are things you ought to talk about, you know? Give President Biden some credit for the good things he's done instead of acting like he's a senile old jackass. But no. You won't do that, because that might actually mean that there's not a horse race for president and then you lose your eyeballs. So they'll keep pushing these idiotic Republican candidates upon us, even though the Republican base has made it clear we don't want them. We don't care about them. We just want Trump. Ring of Fire has fresh content 7 days a week. So if you want to be reminded about it, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, hit the little bell to be notified every time a new video goes up.